following program is intended for mature audiences and is deemed unsuitable for those under the appropriate age group. Viewer discretion is advised. Salutations, everyone. You're probably wondering why I'm in this setup right now. Well, let me tell you. While I was thrifting, because that's what bored people do apparently, I found this weird converter box at a local pawn shop, and the strange thing was that it didn't have a price tag on it. So I asked the owner about it, and he gave it to me for free. So here I am, with this joint, hooked up to my TV, of course. We are going to watch some local television together, so let's watch some Buzzer. Ooh, I can't wait to see some Jim Perry.
Okay. Jordache now presents Jordache Jeans for Kids. The
Well, this is different. Oh well, it's better than watching a channel that recycles the same programming every period. Eh, let's see what else is on. I need something to keep me from doing stupid shit, like lighting paper balls on fire to make a fucking statement.
Are you fucking kidding me? I've been getting complaints all day. What do you mean, excuse me? I'm the boss's son. You crazy? Come on, what are you doing? Do the dishes. Someone make me a burrito. I got a complaint that this is McDonald's, not burritos.
Who is
what is this? I'm the boss's son.
All right.
These are my customers. I'm sorry. These are my customers, man. You make me a burger, ugly. Make me a burger, ugly. Make me a burger.
Wow. What an asshole.
How the hell can shit like this happen? Just because the owner of the restaurant, at least that's why I presume, is your dad, doesn't mean that you're entitled to a free meal. You're not the boss either, you fucking douche. That's not how bosses act either. Commanding an employee to make something for them like some fat ass dictator. Have some common courtesy, you fucking douche.
Are you fucking serious?
Wait a minute. This is another YouTube prank, isn't it? Ah, fucking hell!
YouTube pranksters are divided into two people. Those who know how to prank, and those low-life douchebags who like to piss off bystander people so that they can feel their reactions. Prank vs. Prank and Ed Bassmaster are an example of people who know how to prank, while dickwads like Sam Pepper would do it so wrong that they would get in trouble for it. It's shit like this that would make the person feel like an utter asshole, rather than somebody with a playful sense of humor. To sum it all up, public demonstrations and pranks do not mix at all.
You're fired. Excuse me.
Hey, well, what do you know? It's a Bosco cartoon.
Howdy, 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 folks. Let's sing.
In case you didn't know, Bosco was the very first Looney Tunes character. He was a caricature of a black minstrel character in the South, Al Jolson. However, this idea was dropped in later cartoons so they can have more focus on his adventures rather than his personality, thus dumbing him down, excuse me, smarting him up, to be another happy-go-lucky type of character, like Mickey Mouse or Oswald. His cartoons are not as memorable as the later efforts by the Leon Schlesinger Warner Bros. Cartoon Studio, but his adventures are nice to watch, mainly because he's a naive, harmless, and innocent character.
A dirty fuck!
Wait, what?
A dirty fuck!
Say that again!
Dirty fuck!
Again!
Fuck!
Goodbye!
One opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted. One moment, would you capture it or just let it slip? Yo.
This is the whitest shit I have ever seen.
Poor old ladies.
That's it.
Let's get going.
Finally, something normal for once. Jeez.
Inside the envelope is a letter. You'll find that it explains the details. There are two tickets for belts inside of there. I want you to take your mother with you and leave right now.
You're just gonna leave me?
Are you deaf? Train leaves at 7. Now get going.
But why are you being so kind?
Go before I throw you down on the ground and rape you!
Why does he have to say something like that?
Go before I throw you down on the ground and...
You don't have to say that again!
Well, that came straight the fuck out of nowhere, didn't it? There is no clear basis onto why they inserted that line. It doesn't make any sense! But do you know the real reason why this is the worst line in the anime ever? Look at the girl's reaction!
Go before I throw you down on the ground and rape you!
Bless you, thanks.
Hell no!
Just change the channel, Steven. Just change the channel. And the winner is... Ooh! New segment!
And the winner is going to be a recurring segment for the joint. A sequence of videos will be shown with the recurring theme. The most qualified video will be crowned at the end of the segment.
Now... I need to shut the hell up, so we can start this day. Pat Boone, God bless your heart. But you fucking suck.
What's with the insistent snapping? Is he trying too hard to be hip? Find your rhythm!
Now here's a little trivia for you. This is a cover of Tutti Frutti, Little Richard's signature song. And guess what? This version was more popular than the original. Let that sink in for a moment.
Tutti Frutti, oh Rudy, oh my, 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 my.
Like some of the world already sees me. gonna make a change for once in my life.
Hello. Hello. What's your name?
My name's Onkar Judge.
Okay, why are you here, Onkar?
Because I believe I've got what it takes to wait the X Factor.
Well, I sure hope so.
Are you gonna win?
Yes, I am.
Good.
All right. Here I go then.
What have we done to the world? Look what we've done. What about all the peace that you pledged your only son? Did you ever stop to notice all the children dead from war? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shore?
I thought that was a solid wall.
Wow, that's got to hurt.
It doesn't, it?
Oh. That doesn't hurt. You sure?
No, it doesn't hurt.
Onka, what the hell was that?
Wow.
My voice isn't there, sorry to say. Seriously, I am a true performer. I've been in karaoke finals without looking at the screen, and I've had 95% of the audience on my side.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my God.
I'm going to be honest with you, Onka. It is one of the worst I've ever heard. Wow. It's crazy.
Okay, Simon, moment of truth.
No.
Sorry, Onka.
Sharon.
No, Onka, not this time.
Four no's.
All right.
Thank you very much.
And there's only one judge.
Who's that?
That's me, Onka Judge.
Oh, Onka.
Don't judge the judge, please, because there is only one judge. Because my name is Mr. Onkar Judge.
Very profound words from an awful karaoke singer.
Well, that was ridiculous.
Oh,
and he's broken
that
the
hurt
set.
My ear.
Down the set.
Yeah. Oh my God. Not the meatloaf.
Guys, whenever you're thinking about putting Meatloaf on stage, don't do it again. Your ears will be at stake. Trust me. Okay, so here are my reactions to the nominees. The first one, wow. The second one, goddamn. Third one, Mississippi, goddamn. The first one was bad. Pat Boone could have done a better job at this live performance, and that finger snapping just tears it. But this won't cut it, because this performance just pales in comparison to the next two videos. The second video left me speechless. I mean, God, why does this guy think he's so good? He sounds like what Michael Jackson sounds like if he got his nuts shot at, had molasses shoved down his throat, and watched his theme park burn down. I mean, good grief, what an awful performance! Oh yeah, and a third one. If this performance was used as a torture device to interrogate terrorists, I would not be surprised. So, out of the second and third nominees, which one is the winner? My vote would have to go to the third video, since Meatloaf is a celebrated singer, and he shouldn't have made my ears bleed! I mean, Lord Jesus!
Congratulations, Meatloaf! You're the winner.
Yeah.
This is a test. This station is...
This message means that bad things are up ahead. God help me.
This is a test of the emergency broadcast system. Broadcasters of your area.
Okay. Let's see what the devil has in store for me.
This concludes this test of the emergency broadcast system.
Grandma, can you come out and play?
Sure, Ellie. Oh my, you might want to come here and help Grandma.
What's the matter, Grandma? Can't you stand?
Oh, sorry, honey. It's my knees. They don't work the way they used to.
Does this ever happen to you? Are you on Medicare? You may qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Call the help. If you're covered by Medicare, you may qualify for free delivery.
Grandma, slow down. I can't keep up.
Maybe you can use a knee brace too, Ellie. Catch me if you can, kiddo.
Am I high? Because what the fuck did I just saw?
What the hell is up with the animation on this commercial? It looks like Clutch Cargo, but worse. And if you make me reference Clutch Cargo, then you're in deep shit. And old lady, of course you can't stand up because your ass is glued to that fucking recliner.
Oh my, you might want to come here and help Grandma.
What's the matter, Grandma? Can't you stand?
Oh, sorry, honey. It's my knees. They don't work the way they used to.
I mean, no mean to quote Jessica Rabbit, but Debbie, you were drawn that way. And the end animation is where it delves into the sublime, the surreal, and the ridiculous. How in the fuck does she do that? You can't just sweep away on that rug like that. Cartoon physics doesn't even agree with that principle. And I don't even have to mention the sudden change in design. There are two different grannies. Is this child fucking retarded? That must be another grandma that has fucking Alzheimer's or something. I don't know. That's probably why she's sweeping on that rug, because she's high on her fucking meds. Whoever made this fuck-ass commercial must have been high on PCP and needs to be fucked to death. Yeah, you heard me. They need to be fucked to death.
Okay, what's the number of this dumbass organization?
Call 800-915-8941. That's 800-915-8941. Again, 800-915-8941. That's 800-915-8941.
Okay, I heard you the first time!
Hello, this is the Health Diabetics Organization. I understand that's a call and response to a TV commercial. Is that correct?
Yeah, a pretty fucking shitty one at that. I'm an emotional... state of distress right now. Your commercial was so god-awful that I almost had a heart attack and died. I need a knee brace right now. Thinking about it.
Sir, listen to me.
What?
It's just a commercial.
It's just a commercial? Fuck you, bitch. I'm trying to get something from you right now and you're denying my service just because I'm reacting to your fucking commercial that fucking sucks.
If you'd like to make a call, please hang up.
The fucking bitch hang up on me. Hey, you! What? Shut your fucking ass up! I'm trying to get some sleep around here! God damn it! And boom goes the dynamite. I have a fucking headache. I would give anything to take back what I just saw from this goddamn joint. I am never hooking this joint up to my TV ever again. And I can promise you that.